It's interesting, a lot of people say, well, what do they study here at the War College? Well, we study quite a bit of different things. We work with our students and we try to expand their aperture and open up their worldview and help them see things from the strategic level. So one of the big issues that comes into play here is economics and informational aspects of national power. Those are two things that most of our students don't have a lot of experience with. We spend a lot of time trying to give them some background in that so they have a better appreciation for the different parts of our national government, international fora, different places we engage as a nation. And that's something we try to focus on here. Oh, I frequently use Africa as an example. There's a lot of discussion about national debt here in the United States and how it's a national security concern. And the example I use for Africa is I talk about in the 1970s, there was a major commodities boom in which coffee prices and tin and copper and things that African economies sold on the world market rose in price. And so there was a boom in cash available to a lot of governments in Africa early in their independence era. Unfortunately, the commodities boom ended after the 70s and the prices collapsed, and a lot of governments in Africa had to borrow money to continue operations and take care of their economy and their country. And they wound up in a deep hole because of the debt. So I bring this story in to talk about the Heavily Indebted Poor Countries Initiative, or HIPIC, which was introduced by the World Bank and the IMF, the International Monetary Fund, back in the 1990s, because a lot of these African countries were suffering under crushing debt, and they couldn't fund their militaries, they couldn't pay their salaries for the government employees. Very desperate situation. So this program was created to help them alleviate debt. But it also served a foreign policy goal for the United States in particular. In order for a country in Africa to qualify for these programs, they had to meet certain governance standards. So for instance, they'd have to pay a certain percentage of their national budget for health care for their citizens or education, primary and secondary. And as a consequence, the idea was to help these countries improve their level of development. And so it served a foreign policy goal for the U.S. and Western countries, and it also helped these countries get out of debt. And it's a good example of how a tool like that can help and why that's a national security issue, and how it's also a foreign policy tool for the United States.